the first human to live forever has probably already been born. AI medical technology may be the key to unlocking biological immortality within your lifetime. XPRIZE just announced a $101 million award to any researcher that can successfully reverse aging, and if experts like Ray Kurzweil are right, AI will lead to that breakthrough by the end of the 2020s. While it may be scientifically possible to extend the human life indefinitely, there's no real guarantee that you or I will have access to that medicine. That is, of course, unless you stick around till the end of this video, in which case I'll tell you exactly how we may all be able to live forever. The human life expectancy has more than doubled over the past 100 years. Now, this is just a result of increasing access to healthcare, as well as some major breakthroughs in things like antibiotics and diagnostics. But it's really profound how much just the most basic forms of medicine have drastically improved the lifestyle of so many people. There's no doubt that technological advancements correlate directly to the average human lifespan. The better we get at diagnosing, recognizing, and treating certain disorders as well as trauma, well, the longer people live. But this doubling of the human life expectancy has only just been with traditional medicine. The research is being done by flesh and blood human beings like you and I, but what would a world look like with medical research being assisted by artificial intelligence, which categorically grows at an exponential pace? Does that mean that medicine will also grow at an exponential pace and in turn, human life expectancy? Take a moment to consider this chart. On one axis, we have plotted time, and on the other, the average human life expectancy. As expected, with increases in medical technology, human life expectancy is increasing over time, but there's actually a point where we begin to age backwards. In other words, medicine may well reach a point where it's capable of extending the human lifespan faster than we can age. The real-life impact of this would be humans capable of aging backwards, getting younger by the year until we reach a certain parity. This is known as longevity escape velocity. As profound as this may be, I want you to bear in mind that it only takes into account traditional medical research. We haven't even looked at the effects that artificial intelligence will have on this. Now, before we get into that, I want to ask you real quick to like this video and subscribe to the channel. It really helps me produce this content, but it also helps this message reach as many people as possible. Now that you've subscribed to the channel, let me introduce you to AlphaFold. AlphaFold comes from Google's DeepMind project, and it's an artificially intelligent software which is capable of predicting the ways in which proteins fold in the body. Why is this important, you may ask? Well, let me tell you. Proteins are long-chain amino acids, and the way that they fold determine a great deal of our biology. However, predicting the ways in which they'll fold is incredibly complicated. In order to understand that, you need to understand the way in which the genomic sequence determines that 3D structure. Now, there's been a great deal of research on this over the years, but the problem has always been that it would take a human, basically their entire doctoral thesis, just to predict one single protein fold. However, AlphaFold was able to do this incredibly quickly. The first step in curing aging surely is to understand what causes it. And by solving the protein folding problem, we may be able to predict how these proteins function inside of our bodies, but also be able to use that knowledge to develop more targeted drugs or therapeutics in order to reverse the aging process. Google's AlphaFold project was a major, major leap in being able to do this. It basically broke us free from the confines of our human form, and no longer does it take an entire doctoral thesis just to be able to predict one protein's folding. Now we can do thousands at a time and with a much, much higher accuracy. As incredible as AlphaFold is at peering into our bodies to understand what causes aging, illness, and disease, it's not the only game in town. Take, for instance, Michael Levin's research into what he's calling xenobots. These are small robots which are created out of human cells which can navigate the intracellular space to target and treat specific illnesses. What they've created is kind of a blend between biology and technology. That's why they're calling it xenobots, is they're actually created from human skin, lung, heart tissue. But it's really cool because it's not an outside creature entering your body in a way, something that your human immune system might want to reject, but it's actually a part of you and it's capable of entering your body to heal it. Imagine if you had massive internal damage, but you one day might be able to inject these xenobots to be able to go specifically target that damage, repair it, and then die off and simply be reabsorbed by your body because that's where it came from in the first place. While Michael Levin's team is primarily focused on the physical creation of the actual robots, just imagine what this technology could do with access to even the most basic form of artificially intelligent software. It might be able to detect tumors when they're just microscopic, before they're ever dangerous, and then target them, attack them, and just resolve the issue before it even comes up. These are just two examples of recent breakthroughs in medical technology that I personally thought were really cool, but there are tons of them. But the thing I want you to think back to is that life expectancy chart. It's already predicted that at a certain point, we're going to reach a place in time where we begin to age backwards, and that's just solely based on traditional medical advancements. Try to think about what effect this technology will have on that research. If it's any form of accelerant, it's only going to move that point in time closer to the present. There are plenty of people who make the argument that we've already achieved longevity escape velocity, but we just won't know it until many years afterwards. Regardless of whether this is true or not, it's starting to seem more and more like an inevitability that we're going to reach a point where we age backwards, and the point where that happens just seems to get closer by the day. Okay, I have to admit something deeply personal, and it's that this lab coat totally fit when I purchased it before the pandemic. It doesn't anymore. So let me get this off, and then I want to tell you something real quick. I've only been making these videos for a couple of weeks now, but I gotta be honest, I'm pretty overwhelmed at the response that they've received. We're almost at like 2,000 subscribers already in such a short duration of time. It's got me thinking, is it worth growing this channel? And I really do think that it is. So I went ahead and set up a Buy Me a Coffee link, and just in a couple of short clicks, you can donate to this channel. Any small amount helps. As it is right now, I've been filming and editing these videos on my iPhone, which, while functional, is not exactly the most efficient way to do it. So if you'd like to see more high quality content and more frequently, the best way you can do that is to just make a small donation to Buy Me a Coffee. The link is right up here in the video and in the description. And thank you very much for all of the kind support that everybody's given me so far. So AlphaFold gives us a magnifying glass to look into the human body and understand what causes aging and disease. Michael Levin's Anthrobots may give us a mechanism to be able to treat those specifically, but that's really just interventional medicine. What about preventative therapeutics? Well, David Sinclair's work has primarily focused on the genetic causes of aging, more specifically telomere length. He's isolated a number of nucleotides which are capable of shortening the length of those telomeres. The effective result is reversing aging. Check out this image of two rats, which are actually the same age, but one of them has been given NMN. In the many years that David Sinclair has been working on solving this problem, he was able to isolate only a handful of nucleotides which might achieve this anti-aging benefit. But at the same time, the University of Edinburgh utilized artificial intelligence software to screen through 4,000 different candidates for anti-aging drugs, and within a matter of days, it spit out 21 specific compounds which might have similar effects. Now, obviously, this is just 21 candidates. We still need to do the rats and human research to be able to prove whether this has the effect of reversing aging, but it's an amazing benefit to be able to screen through thousands and thousands and thousands of compounds to be able to narrow it down to 21 very specific compounds. This may have the effect of shortening the research window drastically, leading to more and more rapid improvement in identifying senolytic compounds. In other words, drugs which can make you age backwards. So what do we have? We have a foundation in statistics that we may reach a point where people can begin to age in reverse. And then looking at this research, we can actually see the mechanism of how that might take place. This being couched in a broader trend of artificial intelligence software increasing in capability at an exponential pace, it's only fair to assume that longevity escape velocity is not only an inevitability, but it's just around the corner. But does that mean that we will all live forever? Not necessarily. Historically, healthcare has predominantly benefited only the wealthiest members of society. If we were to look at this same life expectancy chart, but break it up by continent, you would notice that those poorer countries tend to have much shorter life expectancy, and the rate of growth is pretty inhibited, whereas in wealthier Western countries, that rate of increase is much, much more rapid. So this could possibly go one of two ways, right? It's almost an inevitability that the scientific research will lead to longevity escape velocity, but what if it's just like the 1% that has access to this healthcare, and the other 99% just continue to age as normal? What would be the effect? Well, if you had a class of individuals who could live forever and continue amassing wealth throughout their lifetime, as well as influence, effectively what you would get is a sort of like God class of individuals that don't age, can't die, and honestly can't be competed against, while the vast majority of humans have relatively short and unimportant lives. So how can we guarantee that this technology will be used to benefit as many people as possible? Well, there's really only one critical step, and that's to decouple healthcare from the perverse incentive that is profit. So long as longevity medicine is tied to this profit motive, there will be a perverse incentive to limit access to this healthcare to as few individuals with as much resources as possible so that you can maximize your profit. There are certainly a few economic forces which may mitigate this. Deflationary pressures is certainly one of them. As this technology gets cheaper and cheaper, the price should go down respectively, but that's only just assuming that the market's not being manipulated by any form of monopoly or just regulatory capture, right? However, the incentives for manipulating this economy are so profound that honestly, unless there's any intervention by some higher power, i.e. the government or regulatory bodies, there's really no reason for them to democratize this technology. It's highly probable that longevity escape velocity will be achieved at some point in the future, but artificial intelligence is basically like throwing gasoline on this fire. It's not crazy to think that you may be able to live forever, assuming we're able to democratize access to this technology.
It's kind of like we've reached this fork in the road, where we can continue on our current trajectory towards dystopia, or we can do the hard work right now to transition towards a more utopic future. If you want to learn more about that, I'd highly encourage you to check out this next video about the AI job apocalypse. From the bottom of my heart, thank you for all the amazing support that you've all given me so far, and I really look forward to growing this channel with you. I'll see you in the next one.